Hello everybody and welcome to this new Ferris photo video. Today CaptureOne just released the newest update of version 12. This is a free update for everybody who uses version 12, the express version for Fujifilm or Sony, which are free anyway, and of course the pro versions. But before we go any further with the video, if you are not subscribed yet to my channel, click below to subscribe, because a lot more CaptureOne videos are coming in the future. If you don't have CaptureOne yet, or you just want to download the newest version, please click on one of the links below, because then you can go straight away to downloading the newest version or a free trial version, or for more information on the CaptureOne website. So, what is new? First of all, there are new cameras and lenses added to the support. For the Panasonic users, the Panasonic LX100 Mark II has been added, the Leica D-Lux 7 and the Leica C-Lux, and for Nikon, the Coolpix P1000. Then for the Fujifilm users, the Fujinon XF23 1.4 has been released, for Canon, the Canon RF28-17 f2, and for the Nikon Z user, the Nikon Z lens has been added, so the 35-50 40-30 24-70 f4 and 24-70 2.8. Then I think Fujifilm users will get the most out of this update, and the first thing I'm going to tell you, because I can't show yet because I don't have really have time to test it yet, but CaptureOne improved their rendering of X-Trans sensor files and Fujifilm files in general. I already think CaptureOne is the best RAW processor and renderer for Fujifilm X-Trans files, and it just got better, they say. How much, I don't know, but it got better. And this is available in the Express version for Fujifilm and the Pro versions. Then another treat for the Fujifilm users. When you use tethering, and I can turn on my Fujifilm X-T3 over here, I go to tethering. When I go to live view, in the past you couldn't zoom or pan over the image, it was only the general image you got showed. But now you can also use the zoom functions and you can pan along the image. So this has been improved. Then also the overlay function has been improved. For the people who have never used the overlay function, why is it useful? Well, sometimes when you photograph for magazines, for like the cover, magazines already got like a basic mock-up of what the cover is going to be. You can load it into CaptureOne, and when you're doing your portrait session, you can compose your image, and every time when it's loaded into your computer, you can see how it will look on the cover, so you don't have like text line running through the eyes of your model or other strange stuff. It's really easy to use. I'm going to choose file. Then here I got a mock-up of my overlay, and I put it on, and now let's do it on a vertical image. Now you can see it fits nicely. You can use these corners just to stretch it over the image, and mainly thing is the main thing which is improved are the sliders. They respond way better than in the past, and of course you can adjust your opacity. And it's a really easy tool when you want to compose for like magazine covers. So this function has been improved. I could turn it off. Then the next thing which has been improved, those are the functions for grids. And those are really easy as a help for when you want to compose an image. Now let's take a nice image. Let's take this one. In the past you also had grids, but it was only like this, like the standard tic-tac-toe grid. Rule of thirds, but what you can choose now is like the golden ratio or the Fibonacci spiral, and you can flip it, mirror it clockwise, turn it around the one end. You can change the color. Let's put it in like bright pink so you can really clearly see it. And now when I use C and go to crop the image, I can really nicely lay it on my person. Push H again. And it's a really nice tool for helping you cropping slash composing your image. Then last, another thing I can't really show you because I haven't used that in the past, but they added more functionalities for it with AppleScript. And for the guys who want to use it over here are the new added functions. And there have been some bug fixes, and on the Capture One website you can find those. If you have any questions about the newest release, please drop them below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you really liked this video and you want to help me out a little bit, if you want to buy Capture One, please use promotional code FERRY. It doesn't give you a discount, but it helps me growing the channel. And if you want to download it anyway, you can use a link I dropped here below. If you are not subscribed yet to my channel, please click here to subscribe if you want to see some more Capture One videos in the future, and click here for some videos that I've made in the past. This was it for now. I hope to see you soon again. Bye bye.